Welcome everybody to another video. This one's gonna be a little bit different than our other ones. I guess it kind of falls underneath cosplay type of thing, but today we're going to make a mask. It's gonna be a filtered mask, not like a fabric mask like everyone's making on all the websites. Like everyone's making them from home right now. We are gonna make a EVA foam mask that's kind of like a gas mask, but it's not rated for gas. It's the best way to describe it, because we're going to have a mask and we have a filter on it, so it's going to be a filter mask from stuff you can make around from the house. We're going to be going kind of off of what they've been saying, use like 100% cotton fabrics and stuff. We're going to put a little extra stuff in there. We're going to do some fun stuff. This is the first one I'm making, so we're going to be learning together. It's going to be a lot of fun. You're going to want a couple things. Some things you can use from home is like lids. Like I got two lids here. Mine's going to be glued together. It's plastic. They're plastic lids. I'm doing that just because it'd be easier to cut through. We're going to be, other things you could use is like, say a medicine container, old container, but you can like mayonnaise containers, little like metal screw containers, little like old chocolate clip together containers, all kinds of stuff that you can use. And then we got old shirt here we're gonna use. It says 100% cotton on it, just so you guys can see it. Maybe not. Well, trust me, it says 100% cotton. They say that's the best. We also have a mask chart here. I just went online and Googled their search engine of mask templates. It has size for men, teenage women, young kids, small kids. We're going to go for the men's because it's the biggest one. Look at our material. You gotta take this into account. Our material is 1/4 inch thick. We got our hot glue and everything. Cutting devices. And I'm gonna do, so everyone's like, oh yeah, we don't wanna breathe in all this stuff and everything. That's not the only way it enters your body. Your eyes. People spit. I know you probably met someone that just sitting there blah, 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 spitting on you. Gotta protect the eyeballs. So I got an old safety glasses that one of the things broke off. So break off the other one. We got this. So we're going to glue this onto it. We're going to get an overall PPE going. And if you hear everyone saying PPE on the news and everything, personal protection equipment. So we got all of our writing tools, our cutting tools. Just scissors. Don't forget scissors. You're going to need scissors. And kids, do not do this without an adult. Do this with kit. This is a safety video. We're making a mask to stay safe. So, be safe. Don't cut your fingers. Ask for adult's permission if that's what you guys are doing. It'd be a fun project for at home because, hey, we're all cooped up. We're all going insane. That's why I figured we'll make this video. Why not? So, we got our template here. We'll just take some scissors and cut this out. And this one has a guide on it, six inches. So I put it into like Word document and try to do the ruler guide and get to 6 inches the best I could. Okay, so we got that cut out. If you're doing a fabric, it says to cut out 2 main pieces and 2 liner pieces. We're not doing that. We're going heavy duty here. We're going for fun. We're just going to draw out 2 of these. Would be the best way. Try not to waste too much material here. And EVA foam you guys can get at like hardware stores, Walmart, Amazon, but I don't know if Amazon's shipping stuff like this right now. And you can customize it. If you guys are already cosplayers and you have experience with this foam, great. You guys will know the tricks. For people that do not know how to use this stuff, a really great way to customize it is with a heat gun that you can also get at hardware stores, but it's not necessary. Most of my first cosplay stuff never had any heat guns. But it helps get you a nice, well-formed edges. And this is the part you want adult supervision. These are very sharp knives. And you want to make sure they're very sharp, otherwise you will get a very rough edge. In no way is this classified as certified PPE. And we're going to be doing a technique called beveling. And we're going to be cutting an angle on these so they fit together better. Yeah, it's going to go like this, right? And we'll see how the nose works. I was thinking we might have to make a separate piece for that. And the glasses. Let's see if our glasses fit. So this is going to be like stuck together like that. Just take your glasses. We might have to adjust that. We'll see. Like I said, learning together. I guess we'll bevel it for right now, real quick. So when you're beveling it, you definitely want it really sharp. Don't know. I'm going to put a new blade in. Because you don't want a dull blade. Try it. Diminish the sounds here. There you go. Nice fresh blade. And you want a nice cutting board down so you don't ruin whatever surface you're on, but look how smooth that goes now. And you just want to do it like a 45 angle. Just follow that edge. And you can go back over it. Who cares if it's nasty looking? You're never going to see it again because you're going to be gluing these two pieces together. But you do want it to be even so they glue together. There we go. See? Now you got a nice... Ooh, everything's opposite for me. Nice beveled edge. We'll take this piece and do the same thing. Just a little 45. Get it started. Just kind of follow that edge. Watch your finger on this thin spot. Because you don't want... These hurt. They go right into you. So you want to avoid that at all costs. Like I said, this is a safety video. So now when you bend it together, it should just go right to each other. And that's where you're going to put the hot glue is on these spots. Put them together. And like I said, you can use a heat gun. Most people do. You can get it pretty well formed without it. See how much better that fits together? Oh, that's gonna be nice. Might actually be a lot nicer than I thought it was gonna be. We can always fill things in with glue. Add some more, like under the cheek. We can add on. That's the beauty about the foam. It's not supposed to look like anything. We make it look like we want it to look like. And you add on whenever you want. Life's beautiful that way. Okay. Glue gun's still a little cold. So our shirt here. I'm thinking I'm gonna cut up. Close the knife. I'm gonna just cut up the sides. A nice piece of fabric right there. Is it hot yet? It's getting there. It's getting there. So what we're going to do with these pretty much is like, ooh, it's a little sticky. There was a sticker on that. We'll get the non-sticky one. So we're going to want to place, we're going to cut like round spots out of it. And we're going to put hot glue on the inside of this thing in here. So just around the edges in here. And then we're going to place the shirt inside of it. But before we do that, we're going to be cutting triangles or something. I don't know. I haven't figured it out yet. But we're going to be cutting holes in this. We're going to be cutting a circle in this. Because one of these is going to be able to screw into your mask. So, be great. We got a pop bottle here. Since we're waiting for the glue. We'll use an old blade here. Got a little small blade. Be extremely careful on this. Like once you get in, it's gonna go fast. And for the safety glasses, if you could just have like plastic, you could do that too. You're probably gonna wanna clean this stuff really well, cause hey, you're gonna be breathing this. If you don't wanna lick it, you don't wanna breathe through it. Not saying you should lick this stuff, but you understand what I'm saying. I said this is really nasty. You're gonna want to clean this, but we're gonna be using this to attach this to one of the lids so you can have this on your mask and have something to screw onto. So I'm gonna put this aside right now because it's dirty and I'm gonna wipe my hands off real quick. Glue smells hot. Oh, it's starting to drip. Perfect. There we go. Make sure your thing is still all nice and round. And I think, which one would be easier? Get some glue on there. Don't be bashful. And if the glue squirts out the front, it's fine. Leave it. If you mess with it when it's hot, it's not going to look pretty. spill on it. If you got a nice spot, you can have like a bowl and then have like a spray bottle or something, or water bottle, and kind of drain some water on it. It'll cool down a little faster, so you don't have as much wait time. And just glue along up this here. Set this aside. I can go work on this. Cut this out. I don't know if this will work. I haven't tried it yet. It should work. I don't see why it wouldn't. But we're going to try to use the X-Acto knife to cut this out. Okay. Well, from that side that I started cutting, I got to be able to cut through to the center. So I'm starting to make some progress. Now I might be able to get my scissors in. Maybe have some heavier duty scissors than these. There we go. I'm gonna just try to cut out as much as we can. And see if we can get this thing around to the edges. So we can just follow it out. This might be able to. If you guys got drills or something, probably be a better bet. Maybe a hole saw drill. Just kind of put it on there and just. But anyone that doesn't have the tools to do this, here you go. This is how I'm doing it. For this one, we're doing a hole in the center. And I'm just using a 2-liter bottle lid. You want to get as center as you can. There's a little circle there. I don't know if you guys can see on mine. There's a little circle right there. And it helps if it's sticky. And then you can just draw it out. Remember, this hole, the circle is going to be bigger than this. Probably fix that with hot glue if you mess up, but let's try see what we can do to get it the right size. This would be a great time to use a drill. Probably be safer. You know what? Here, I found a way. I started here. I just kind of pushed it in and just cut across. I just went straight across. Oop, can't get out. There we go. So we got a nice cut. I'm going to do another one that way. I'll show you this time. Start in the center. Kind of rock it. A cross cut there. Like I was saying, the drill would probably be your best bet here. You can kind of cut off the tips of these corners. Of these triangles. You get a little nice square in here. Three people without drills. I have a drill, just not in the house. And I'm not bringing my equipment, recording equipment, out to the shop. So you see that? You see our old triangle cut? Well, we cut off all the corners. Now we can get our scissors in there. Let's see what type of damage we can do. Not to ourselves, to the lid. Remember, spirals are our friends on this. And kids, just because I can do it does not mean it's easy, does not mean it's safe. Get a parent. We got our bottle cap here. It's pretty close. I think that's good enough. It's close enough. Okay, so we're back. We need to cut a hole in this before we glue it to that. Just be very careful. That should be good enough. Again, use a drill. If you have one, be 10 times easier. But see, what we got going here is now you can screw it on. And we're going to glue it to this. And then you can unscrew it. And it's going to be like that. So it attaches. We will be putting a hole or something. Got all the spider webs. It's just what I call the glue. We'll be putting it on the side. Whatever side you want, I don't care. I was thinking about making a flat spot here. So you can put it on the front. I mean, we still could. If you guys want to see a different design with it on the front, let me know in the comments. We can do that. No big deal. So, but this one, since I'm right-handed, I'm going to want it on the right side, just so you can screw it off, screw it on. Yeah, so we'll put it there. So what you can do, is you want to make sure it fits. And for like me, right here, it's kind of getting in the way of my cheeks. So you want to kind of make where it's kind of bothering. Okay, so for figuring out where to put this, I'm going to put it like this. And since it's a sharp edge, I'm kind of just going to slightly press on it. And here, I'm gonna slightly press down on it. Just put fingers behind it and just spin it. You should get a nice circle. And what we're gonna do is cut out that circle. And probably should have done this when it was still flat. That going on. Okay, we can just pop that out the back. Might need to cut them off the back. I was able to pull them all off. Here we go. You can put it this way, or you could put it. Can we put it this way? Try to push it through. Try to get. There we go. That's what we wanted. And we're gonna put hot glue on this side because this is sharp. It's gonna. It wouldn't be not. It would definitely not be comfortable on your face. We're gonna put hot glue out here. You could also do like gauze. Pack gauze in there. Cotton balls. Cotton balls would be a great one. Like you place the shirt in here, right? And pack it full of cotton balls. And then put them together. Cotton balls I know would be safe because they're cotton. That's a go. Do the cotton balls. So we're going to take our glue gun. Glue around this edge. For our pop bottle lid. Make sure it's really on there. Get enough glue on it. Seal those holes. We don't want holes. We're doing this for air filtration. We don't want air getting through. Unfiltered air getting through. Okay. We wanted to glue this. I think I'm going to glue the back side first to hold it in. Okay, so I got a new pen. I got these drawn out. So now we're going to cut them out, okay? Grab your scissors. We got one. And we're going to put that. Make sure it fits. See, this is kind of the problem that we're going to run into. With not having... Got those spider webs on here. With not having a crossbar here. So if you have some plastic that you can run across it, some foam. I think that worked brilliantly. That gives a cool design. Cool, unique design. Just cut that right there. There's all types of uses for excess foam. There we go. So since it's the extra foam that I used from beveling this piece. So you get this kind of cool little dome shape. Like a But we're going to be putting this. See how much nicer that sits in there? Until you poke it. Yeah, we're going to be stuffing it in here. And gluing it around the edges. But we're putting the glue in first. And so, just... And after you put the glue in, you might want to let it sit for a little bit. So it's not like super hot when you stick your fingers in there. But still pliable enough to get your shirt to stick. Kind of just go around a couple times, make sure it stays hot, get a nice rim going. Okay. It cools down fairly quick, so I'm going to go in and start placing it in. You just kind of want to stick it, just tuck it in. A cool trick that you can do is run the hot glue gun over the glue area again and heat up the glue underneath as you're applying more glue. So you just kind of want to push it in there. Oop. I'm gonna go around and glue the edges down there, sticking up around, so we have a little bit more of a base to keep it from peeling up like I started having it happen just now. Just put a bunch of glue in there. You want to be very careful not getting it in the center, because that's what we're breathing through. And you can get it on the edges, it's fine, because we're not screwing this into anything. It'd be cool to make one that screws together so you can just change out the filter internals. That'd be for another complex video if you guys want to see that. So you guys should be able to see all the glue on the inside. And of course, we're going to pull out these spider webs. Don't want those. Those don't help filter the air. It's really hard to look up at you guys. Don't even know why I tried. So we're going to let that cool. It's getting pretty hot. We've got to cut this out, glue it into here the same way. This one's going to be a little easier because it's already flat. I'm going to quickly go through that. You guys don't need to watch that twice. And because you guys got replay. Like I was telling you. We know cotton balls are safe. We know cotton is what we're supposed to be doing. So we're going to try it out. Should work pretty well. I'm going to shove them in. Try to get as many as you can in there. Maybe we can pull these apart. Let's see if this is ready. As you guys can see, it's starting to look like a filter now. Like, you got your screw in part, got your face design. It's just gonna screw onto this like that. I'm gonna screw it on now, just so you guys can see kind of what's going on. Oops. Come on. What's going on? There we go. So it kind of looks like that. It's not screwed on all the way because I'm trying to let the glue dry. But we're starting to get a gas mask, or not gas mask, sorry. A purified air breather. You're starting to see it come together now. I don't know what type of designs you guys want to do to customize it. Make it look fancy. Make it your own. You want to make sure it's nice and tight. Yeah, we're starting to get something here. So we wanted to do our glasses. Move this out of the way. If you want to do your eye PPE on these, I think I'm gonna glue it on first. And then figure out how to attach foam to it. I feel like that's going to be the easiest way to do this. So we're going to grab our glue gun here. And I think it might be easier to glue directly to the nose piece of the glasses and stick it on so we have kind of an idea where it's going to be. And I'm just sticking it on the edge of it. So I'm just right on the edge. Kind of straightforward, like where you'd be looking. And then just let it sit. Kind of make sure it's even the best you can. The glue's probably going to run a little bit. But that's kind of what it's going to look like. It's going to be like a painter's mask. Ooh! Almost had a drastic devastation there with our painter's mask. Put that pen there. And then we're going to try to find some pieces to put on there. We're probably going to put pieces along the top that goes against your forehead. So you have a nice, like, enclosed face cover. Okay, everyone. So how are we going to figure this out? Kind of thinking we're going to kind of just take a piece of foam, scrap foam, any foam, whatever you got. Try to put it up underneath this thing. And try to mark it. If you want to use your blade, you can do that, or a pen, preferably, I guess, would be the perfect one. And just draw the line of your glasses. Then we're going to cut that out, kind of try to form it the best we can. So we're going to do our little like 90 degree bevel like we did earlier. And you can do whatever shape you want on the bottom. I'm just doing it because of how it. There we go, we got a piece now. So you want to make sure you have the soft side to the soft side to make sure it's transposing correctly so we don't have that problem. I can work on beveling this. Seems like our blade is getting a little dull. If you guys haven't noticed, there is a little thing on the back of these blades, knives, that you can pop the blade off. There we go. Now we got a fresh blade. Much better. You can get blue, like whatever color Sharpie you're using. I usually use a Sharpie. Shows up better. It's gonna get all over your hands. Be prepared for that. If you don't want it on your hands, wear gloves. Wear some rubber gloves or something. Now we can see how well this is gonna fit into our glasses. We're gonna have to bend it. Form it, shape it, like we did with our cheek pieces. We might have to bevel down the side here. Yeah, I think so. So, we're gonna bevel down the side. And I think I'm gonna start like part the way down. I don't want to go all the way back because I kind of want it to wing out. And so when you do that, you kind of just want to eventually just come out flat. Yeah, it doesn't go all the way up, and you just kind of, you got your flat area right here, and kind of just curved into it. That's what you want. And then you'll put it in here on your glasses. So what I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna glue this part first to there, and then bend it, shape it, and glue it. But eventually it's gonna look like that. Oop. But I am going to have this back part glued to the top of the guard, so for the cheek, so they're going to line up. So you want to take a piece of glue, dab it right there. Attach it there. We'll be bringing this over to this, which will narrow down the gap right there. And that's what both sides are going to be like. Okay, everyone. So this is what we got going now. This mask here. And of course, this is what it screws onto, right? You guys know that. But I went in and I glued all underneath the glasses here, so there's no spots where there's air coming through. It's kind of starting to look like a fighter mask, like a airplane fighter. So we're gonna, I took a piece like this. As you guys can see, it's just the snap together part to make the edges look finished. Took one of those, cut the little nubs off, and now I have this. And this is going to be our crown of our helmet. So we're going to glue it to these two foam pieces right here. We're going to glue to here first, wrap it around, glue it to the glasses, and shape it, and then glue it to this part here. Okay, everyone. So here we are. I got that glued on. Starting to get a mask going together. Looking pretty good. We got our glasses in. I know it's not very pretty, but once it starts getting really dry, you can like take your X-Acto knife and like take that off. Take it off and then scrape it. Try not to scratch your lens too much. But yeah. Maybe I'll do another video on attaching it, unless you guys want to attach it yourselves. There you go. You got your Corona mask or something. I am thinking about doing a bottom plate. Okay, everyone. So we are doing the base plate for this video. And so that's just to close off this. So we're not getting as much air coming in. Like I said, seal, seal, seal. That's what we want to do here. So I just got a corner piece here. And you want to make sure the flat is going out, make it look nicer. And what we're going to do is we're going to place it on here. Let's see if I can show you. I want to do as little cutting on this curve as I can. And this was just a scrap that had a curve. If you guys want to take like something round, a coffee tin maybe, and get that curvature, put it on there and trace it, that'll work. I just had a piece that happened to be curved. So that'd be great. I want to get these corners to the edge of that curve so I don't have to cut any more of the curve. And we got extra spots in. So we're going to trace the outside here. So get it on the curve. Get your marker out. And if you guys want to see a like full encompassing mask, so coming back like this, let me know and I will make a video for that. But as for this video, this is going to be the end of it. I do have these cool elastic bands I think I'm going to be using. I'm going to glue inside the mask and it's going to go like on the back here. I'm going to have one for the top and one for the bottom. As you see, I have two. And that's what I'm going to be doing, because it seems like the easiest way. And if you guys have any questions at all, or comments, please feel free to leave them in the comments. If you guys want to see a different video on mask stuff, or anything, just jump down those the comment box down below. So we're gonna attach it right here. If you want to make it look a little cooler, I guess you can bevel it down so it doesn't look so blocky. I think we're gonna do that. I'm gonna need a new blade though, because mine is starting to get dull to do a bevel. Oh, come on, let go. There we go. So I want to get a new blade. Probably best to start from here, but since I'm going to bevel here and here. So here's your curve. And since this is going to be, you want a flat side to bevel from, we're going to bevel here first and then come back to this corner and bevel here. Because if you already beveled this part and you try to bevel this one, it's going to be very difficult. So make sure you start on the right spot. Watch your fingers. There you go. See? We got a nice little bevel edge. And we got our curve. And so that's going to look like this on there. Kind of got like a beak looking thing going on. Okay, so we had our glue ready. I forgot the camera was not on. So we're gluing it on now. And I just put the glue on the base of the helm or the mask and not the base plate, because we don't really know where we want the glue on the base plate. And if your helmet's like mine, I have a gap in there at the bottom. So we're going to be gluing that in, filling that up. Yeah, I think the glue's pretty much hardened. And so we got our completed mask. Got your base plate there. Got your mask. It fits pretty well to my forehead. And once you get the elastic on, it'll fit tighter. And I'm going to put like elastic up here. An elastic down here, so it's fully pulling on your head. I might crisscross these, or maybe even put like a dot here of like glue, because mine actually have holes on it, and you can like hook it to that, and then hook it down here and have it crisscross. So you're not having two bands and have it fall off your face and whatnot. But yeah, that was the build. And if you guys want to see more videos on this, adding special attachments or whatnot, let me know in the comments. I really appreciate you guys for watching this video. Stay safe out there, guys. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share with your friends. And most important, have an amazing day.